Hi dear students, we'll be seeing today cubital fossa. So before seeing cubital fossa, please refer to the video where we have discussed about the muscles of the upper limb so that you can understand what is cubital fossa. Let's begin. Cubital fossa is located anterior to the elbow joint and is a triangular depression formed between the two forearm muscles. So it is seen in front of the elbow joint and it is formed between two muscles. The two muscles are brachioradialis laterally and pronator teres medially. Now brachioradialis is originating from lateral supracondylar ridge of humerus. Pronator teres muscle originates from medial epicondyle of the humerus. So it's a gap or it's a space, it's a hollow space between the two muscles where it has a lot of contents. So triangular area depression. So it is homologous to the popliteal fossa in the lower limb. Let's see the boundaries of cubital fossa. The base is by drawing a line joining two epicondyles of the humerus. Laterally by the brachioradialis, so specifically the medial border of the brachioradialis, and medially pronator teres, precisely the lateral border of the pronator teres muscle. Roof is formed by the skin, superficial fascia, deep fascia, and bicipital aponeurosis, which is a part of biceps muscle, and the floor is made of two muscles, brachialis muscle, which is medially, brachialis muscle is lying deep to biceps brachii, that you cannot see here, but there is a muscle deep to it, so that is forming the floor. And laterally there is another muscle that also cannot be seen here, that is supinator muscle. Contents of cubital fossa, from medial to lateral, they are the median nerve, then the brachial artery, biceps brachii tendon, and the deep branch of ulnar nerve. Deep branch of radial nerve. So these contents from medial to lateral: the median nerve, the brachial artery, then the biceps brachii tendon, then the deep branch of radial nerve. So you can remember here it as M, from medial to lateral, M B B R. So M for median nerve, B for brachial artery, the next B for biceps brachii tendon, and R for radial nerve. And here we can see the floor muscles like brachialis, which is deep to biceps brachii, and the supinator also can be seen in this area, that forms the floor. And the deep branch of radial nerve will pass between the two heads of supinator onto the posterior compartment of forearm. Now let's see the structures in little detail. The median nerve, that is lying immediately medial to the brachial artery, and leaves the fossa by passing between the ulnar and humeral heads of pronator teres muscle. Pronator teres muscle has got two heads: ulnar head, which is originating from the ulna, and a humeral head, which is originating from the humerus. So the median nerve, which lies medial to the brachial artery, that leaves the cubital fossa by passing between the two heads of pronator teres, that is between the humeral head and the ulnar head of pronator teres. Now the brachial artery and the median nerve are covered and protected anteriorly in the distal part of cubital fossa by bicipital aponeurosis. So both the structures, median nerve and brachial artery, they are protected well by the bicipital aponeurosis, which is an extension from the biceps brachii muscle during its insertion. Of course, it is inserted as biceps tendon, but an extension of it from there to the posterior border of ulna, that is called bicipital aponeurosis, that protects these structures. Coming to the radial nerve lies just under the lip of brachioradialis muscle, which forms the lateral margin of the fossa. So it is lying just deep to the brachioradialis muscle. And in this position, the radial nerve divides into a superficial branch and a deep branch. The superficial branch continues in the forearm, just deep to the brachioradialis muscle. Whereas I already mentioned the deep branch that will pierce or that will pass between the two heads of supinator muscle, because supinator also has two heads, and it passes between the heads and reaches the posterior aspect of the forearm and continuing there as posterior interosseous nerve. Now, roof of the cubital fossa is formed by the skin, superficial fascia. The most important structure within the roof is the median cubital vein, which is connecting the cephalic and the basilic vein. Cephalic vein lies laterally and basilic vein lies medially. Other structures within the roof are cutaneous nerves, and they are the lateral and the medial cutaneous nerve of forearm. Lateral cutaneous nerve of forearm is a continuation of muscular cutaneous nerve that lies along with the cephalic vein. Medial cutaneous nerve of forearm, that is a branch of the medial cord of the brachial plexus that lies along with basilic vein. Thank you.